times per second, you get information of the position of each wire. Well, that's interesting because if you have position data, so often it's very accurate, you can get information about technical aspects of the game. You get a lot of information about fitness aspects of the game. You can monitor your training log. You can also, and that's important, monitor the execution of the training, what's the quality of the training, how's the performance in the training. You can do that every day. And that's also vision. What we want often, that the demands in training are higher than games. Well, with this system, we can directly, during or after training, give feedback to our players. And that's crucial in keeping and setting where performance makes a difference. And in training, it makes a difference. This is an example of what we do in training, but also what part of information we get out of it. This is a sprint capacity training. You could call it a high intensity exercise set training. It's you are producing lactate in this training. You do 28 sprints of 15 meters. You have 12 seconds rest in between the sprints and 4 minutes between the series. And with this type of data, you can look at the power they produce, peak velocity. It's acceleration, and with 50 meters, you never reach your maximum velocity. And you can look at capacity. And for example, these are the defenders, the midfield players, and the attack players, the offensive players. What you see is that the power peak velocity is much higher in that group. The defenders are intermediate, and you see we have low values for our midfield players. You can do that also on individual base. Here you see again the four series for a defender we measure, for a midfield player, and for an offensive player. And what you see over here is that this guy has the highest power of all three, and actually of the whole team. But he, for him, four series is actually quite easy, but also the fourth series, he can maintain his high power without any problems. For this guy, capacity is not a big problem. It's easy for him to do that many sprints, but his absolute power is quite low. So for him, if you're thinking, what should I do? Maybe a program, extra program, directly. Power training would be very interesting. But the key thing is it a limiting factor in the game? And we have a lot of game data, so we know also for him in game situation, is speed or acceleration, is acceleration actually a limiting factor in his performance? Because you want to do so many things with them. And 80% of the season, you have 3 games in a week, you have to make a choice. Especially this type of training, well, it takes up a lot of recovery time, 48 hours to 72 hours. So you have to be very careful for planning this type of training in the season. For this guy, this one is a defender. He came back from an injury. You see that his power output is quite a lot, but he had problems maintaining that power output of the 4 series. So for him, it could be worthwhile capacity training and more capacity training. So it's actually a normal training setting, and with our system, measure system, we get quite easily that type of information. And based on that type of information, you can look at 3 weeks ago, we did the same training session. How did he develop? How did he score in relation with the other guys in the team? So you have benchmarks, and you can monitor your players. Quite easy. This is another example. This is a small sided game with goalkeeper. I think it's a very, very important aspect in our training, but there are many more important aspects in our training and exercise. So it's not that we only do small sided games. We have also athletic power training, we have sprint training, we have passing drills, we have system exercises, we have a game exercise. So it's an element in your total training program. Now what we measure here is the distance they run in 2 minutes. We did 10 times 2 minutes in total. Extra overtime on the 10 serial repetition, you see actually no decrease in distance. Here you see the intensity of that training session. Well, it's around 90 to 92%. That's okay. That was our objective in this training, so that's fine. Here you see the speed index. It's a combination of time in different time zones. And it's important because over time we see don't see any change or decrease. And the recovery heart rate is about 20% of the maximum heart rate. So in this training session we get information that the intensity is okay. We know from earlier the same type of training, how do they perform, what is the work output in this training, and in terms of capacity, we know 10 reps 2 minutes is actually not a problem, so we can make a decision that we go to 11 or 12 reps of 2 minutes, or maybe we go to 2.5 minutes. Actually, every training exercise is measured in this way. So, for every training exercise, we know what the physical work is they have to do. Here you see a triangle, there's this exercise. Search a line and a position play, and what you see is that these type of passing exercises give quite different physical picture in the triangle. The distance run and sprint is the most, but in the search line you see that they sprint more. So based on that type of information, you can fit that this type of training exercise in your periodization, in your planning model. So the advantage is now that for every training exercise, we know for the team and on the individual level what the training load is. We have a benchmark for every client, how they perform, and over the season we can actually monitor our players in this aspect of physical work. Short wrap up of our findings. We have to understand that the coach is always the reference in judging performance of the team and the individual player, and it's always in relation to the system of play. And that's one of the problems at the moment with the events we get. We get how many passes. For example, Barcelona had twice as much passing as Manchester United, maybe 3 times. But that in itself is not a performance factor. Because Manchester didn't want them to have the ball. They gave Barcelona the ball, but the moment they got the ball, that was their moment, and that was the moment they should get the chance. So it's always in relation to the system of play. But I think we need additional quantitative information about the game. The work performance in a physical sense, but also in a technical sense. I think the supporting staff, and Holland, we are very fond of embedded sport.